Electric.
Yeah, yeah.
We're gonna be out in Chicago. Good for Jewish.
Sunday morning, Rocky, and if you had to bet on who's going to make it into the finals, who would you choose?
I would definitely go with my boys, Lanch. Avalanche, actually, it would go Dynasty, Avalanche, Naughty Dogs. That would be my pick if I had to throw some cash out. That would be my Vegas pick right there.
There it is. And if I had to choose, I'd choose Dynasty in first place, Russian Legions in second place, because I really want them to take the money back, and I love those guys. Naughty Dogs in third place, that's my choice.
Now, let's take a closer look at the pro quarterfinalists. And after we check out the pros, I'll be hanging out, chilling with the dogs. Dynasty out of San Diego, going into the quarterfinals on top, first place. Boys from Southern California look like they just might pull off another win, with superstar players like Ollie Lang, Ryan Greenspan, and Alex Frazee. They will be hard to beat.
Coming in, chomping at Dynasty's heels, the Naughty Dogs from the Pacific Northwest. The Dogs have been looking strong and playing aggressive all weekend here in Vegas. Should be interesting to see how Dynasty handles the bite of the Dogs.
The Bushwhackers, another strong California team that has moved up from the amateur ranks, proving that they deserve to be in the professional circuit.
The Russian Legion traveling all the way from Moscow, Russia, to show the American teams and claim the victory on U.S. soil.
The Tauntauns from France. These are the European champions. After just missing the payoff in Huntington Beach, they need to come back and see if they can take the title away from Dynasty.
Team Nexus, the bad blokes from Britain. These players have been around for a while, with players from Shockwave, Banzai, and the Mayhem Tigers. The combination of experience and youth, this team is definitely one we should be watching. Joy Division. The Swedes are here in full effect and ready to throw paint. These party animals in leopard jerseys from Stockholm play aggressive and are the leading team from Scandinavia.
This team should be winning it. You know it. Everybody here knows that.
Avalanche from Denver, Colorado. Captained by the Flame Ham himself, Ed Poorman, has been a powerhouse team for the last 5 years. Avalanche has a new fresh lineup, so time will tell if they can compete with the top dogs.
What's up? Rocky Cagnone here, hanging out with Naughty Dogs, pro team. Rocky, where do the dogs hail from? Where are you guys out of? Where's home?
Well, 90% of us are from the Northwest, Oregon. We have a couple guys from Southern California and a guy from Utah and one guy from Seattle.
What makes the dogs tick?
I think most of it is I want to run it like a professional organization. You know, we're here on our sponsor's dime, and I want to definitely represent them the best I can, and out partying at night isn't one of them. Getting drunk, it's not one of them. The guys can do that on their own time. But when they're at the tournament, they're on our time. So that's it. You know, I think one of the biggest things that makes up our team is the core players. You know, we've had, like I said, the same six or seven guys since the beginning, and we just keep inserting guys until, you know, we find the perfect fit, and I think we found it.
Pretty much me, Rocky, Brian, and Trevor. And Kessel have been on the team since
team started.
You play with the same people over and over again, it makes it a lot easier. You know, I can play with Rocky and Raymond and Big B and all those guys, and I can just tell what they're going to do without even communicating. And we got some new guys, but they're awesome, so it just makes it super easy.
Brad, Eric, you guys are new on the team, you guys are pumping it up. What made you want to come join the Dogs? I mean, any special reason behind it?
Well, I think they're a proven team. You know, they go out there, they do it every tournament. You know, they're always up in the top, you know, finals. They're always doing it, you know, and who wouldn't want to play for a team like that?
Sonny, you've been around the block a few times. You're from SoCal, been on the scene for quite a bit. I mean, you play with some of the top pro teams. What's different about the Naughty Dogs?
Probably the main difference is just a lot of the other teams I went with, we'd go out and party all night till like 4 in the morning and get crazy and then try to drag ourselves out of bed and play the game and try to win a tournament. But with this team, it's family run, family orientated. We actually got a curfew. Rocky actually comes and checks our beds and makes sure we're there. So the party aspect is gone. Like, we're there to do a job, we're there to represent our sponsors, and we do the absolute best job we can.
Core, what's a typical practice day with the Dogs?
Intense. We practice. Our best competition is each other. We usually have close practices, and front players do a job. I mean, we do, like, sometimes we have front players run the bunker. We don't lane them. Sometimes we do, and they won't know it. So they just have to run the bunkers.
And approximately, then, how many games do you get in a day?
20 or 30.
Wow, you guys are pumping it in.
Our paint sponsors love us.
You guys had some really, really, really good games this year. What is it like to go up against some of the top pros and just mow them down?
It's been great. It's been a good experience. Couldn't ask for more this year. It's like, couldn't play against any better players out there.
What's going on in your head, say, when you play a powerhouse team or a top team like Avalanche or Dynasty?
Kill, kill, kill. And I got my boys behind me, and I just go crazy. I don't know.
All right, Mikey, we're around the campfire. You're blowing up right now. We got to see you in action a little bit earlier. Give us a little bit about your style of play and what you're going to bring to the team.
I'm pretty fast, so, you know, play front. Got a pretty good snapshot. I'm just trying to work on, you know, being more aggressive, making those aggressive bills, and just trying to be a more complete player.
What's in the future for the Dogs? I mean, what are you guys holding in the future? Any secrets?
Yeah, domination.
There you have it.
I called you on the phone, hoping that what we shared wasn't truly gone. I pretended I was cool when I heard your voice that night. I felt like such a fool. We can try to work it out. If I finally get you back, I'll make you scream and shout. Whoa-oh.
Bushwhackers, Naughty Dogs, Game 1 of the semifinals. Naughty Dogs, known for their sweet spotting skills off the break, take it to the Bushwhackers right from the gate.
The Bushwhackers, definitely not afraid of the fire lanes and try to run right through them.
It's a constant movement on both teams. Naughty Dogs, with their guns up, they have the momentum going in their direction. Effort by the Bushwhackers to stop the onslaught from the Dogs.
But it's much too late. The Dogs have done their damage, and they're ready to clean it up.
aggressive breakout, just like the first game. The Dogs, they know the vital lanes to shoot.
Bushwhack is constantly taking that 40.
But this is what makes the Naughty Dogs a winning team. Double movement, just like that.
Yeah, they totally play as a team.
Bushwhackers trying to make ground, but just get whacked. The Dogs have those lanes locked down.
The Bushwhackers don't know where it's coming from. The Naughty Dogs see the moves before they even happen.
Shooting skills like that, the Dogs will make the podium.
The Bushwhackers are making a beeline straight to the dead box. The Naughty Dogs making it to the finals, and they're going for first place.
This is the second semifinals, Russian Legion against Dynasty. Both teams come out guns a-blazing, coming out hard.
Dynasty locking down those lanes and making sure that the Russians don't make any power moves. Dynasty using those machine guns correctly, manhandling the Russians for a victory in game one. Russian Legion against Dynasty. This is the second game. Dynasty throwing a barrage, a whole wall of paint. Get some key eliminations on the Russians.
Tournament. Oliver Superstar Lang, he goes through this game, takes out at least four or five Russians with sweet moves, sweet snap shootings. The kid is just unbelievable.
It's the OL knife dipping into the Russian butter.
Dynasty butchers the Russians, beats them two straight games. The first place battle is going to be Dynasty versus the Naughty Dogs. Russian Legion against the Bushwhackers, finals game one.
Here we have the incredible team, the Russian Legions from Moscow, Russia.
And the boys from Huntington Beach, California, USA, the Bushwhackers. Huge breakout, sprint to their first primary bunkers. Looks like they're setting up good there, Will.
And here we have it, the very first kill off of the Bushwhackers. Craig Frascone leaving the field nice and early.
Alex Soloviev from the Russian Legions got hit on the breakout. Ooh, and Kanazi at the tombstone takes a hit also.
As a double move to the 40 happens.
And that was a mistake by the Russians, and he's definitely going to pay for it right there. Yeah, he's getting pulled. He's taking a walk to the
deadlocks. He was actually supposed to stop at the stand-up and back up the middle 40 guy. They could pay for that one.
They're definitely. And look, and the taco guy, Morozov, also takes it. He's walking the dead box also.
There it is. The Russian machine is starting to break down.
It is 6-on-3, huge numbers like this. I have to say right now, this game is in huge favor of the Bushwhackers.
Yes, and Andrew Fish, Garden Cheer, knows it too, as both from the Russian Legion and the Bushwhackers make their way.
Huge power move across the 50 into the Russian territory.
By the Fishman himself. Vlad Gorgova needs to gut that fish right now just to give the Russians any chance of winning.
Ooh, and fish tattoos. Vlad, the impaler in the back. Good move to the outside, small brick.
Incredible move, and that is a key move for this tournament so far.
Fish is just taking people down left and right. And there we go. Out the back, stand up. So Dolnikov, Fish is just on fire this game.
Yes, and we have number 3, Olenin, the last man remaining for the Russian Legion.
Oh, Olin's gone. I'm telling you, Bushwhackers mowed right through the Russians. I mean, one person can turn the game around, but Will, not 1-on-6.
Not a chance, not at this level of competition, for sure. And there goes the Fishman in all his glory. Andrew the Fish, Garden Cheer, pulls it off for the Whackers.
And here's the replay of the first game.
Russians getting their guns up, and as you can see, Fish making the 40 middle.
I'm telling you, Fish was a huge key in this game. I'm going to start calling him the Great White.
And after stabbing Vlad the Impaler, I would call him the Great White, too.
That kid was on an insane killer feeding frenzy. Now, the Russians are going to have to go back to the drawing board because they need the second game.
Here we are, game 2 of the finals. We have the Bushwhackers versus the Russian Legion. Game on, the Russians coming out real safe-like, taking the spectator tombstone, as well as the non-spectator tombstone, the middle stand-up, the very far back stand-up, and playing so safe. Green light all the way, all Russians are alive.